Hey guys.
Hey Bo.
Hi Bo.
Flippin' Physics.
Ladies and gentlemen, people, the bell has rung, therefore class has begun, therefore you should be seated in your seat, ready, excited to learn about how to use significant figures. We just learned about significant figures, now we're going to learn about how to use them. Before we can talk about exactly how we work with the significant figures in physics, we actually need to recall how to round. Basically, it works like this. I'll write the rounding rules on the board. The two rules of rounding are, if the number ends in a number greater than 5, you round up, and if a number ends in something less than 5, you round down. Bo, please round 36.0501 to 3 significant digits.
Well, the number ends in 501, which is greater than 5, so we round up to 36.1.
Great. Bobby, please round 0.01249 to 2 significant digits.
Because the number ends in 49, which is less than 5, then we round down to 0.012.
Great. Now let's talk about how we actually work with significant figures in physics.
Mr. P, isn't there some rule about ending in a perfect 5? Shouldn't we go over that one?
I guess we should go over that one. However, I warn you that after I present this rule, many students get overzealous with it and want to apply this rule when it shouldn't be used. With that caveat, here we go. Rule number 3. If the number ends in a perfect 5, in other words, all or no zeros after the 5, you round to the even number. I like to call this the arcane rounding rule because it is a rule that is truly understood by few. So let's give it a try. Billy, how would you round the number 26.5 to 2 significant figures?
Well, it ends in a perfect 5, so we round to the even number, or 26.
Yes, 26 has 2 significant figures. And Bo, please round 275 to 2 sig figures.
That would be 280. Round to the even number, it ends in a perfect 5.
It is very important that you understand why the arcane rounding rule exists. It's because of statistics. If we rounded up when ending in a perfect 5 every time, then all of the data would actually be artificially increased. It would all go up. With the arcane rounding rule, 50% of the time we round up and 50% of the time we round down, and the data is not artificially inflated. Also, this is how I remember the arcane rounding rule. It is a doubly odd rule because it is doubly odd that we round to the even number and not the odd. Yes, that is how I remember it.
Okay.
Moving on. You should know that when you add or subtract numbers, you round to the smallest number to the right of the decimal. In other words, Bo, what is 56.1 plus 23.22?
However, the smallest number to the right of the decimal was 56.1, and therefore we round to one number to the right of the decimal, or 79.3.
Yes, you should also know that when we multiply or divide numbers, we end with the number that has the least number of significant digits from our measured or given values. For example, Billy, what is 1030 multiplied by 5.1.
Well, I'm gonna have to get my calculator out for that one. Let's see, 1030 times 5.1 is 5,253. But we need 2 significant digits because the least number was 2 from the 5.1. Therefore, because it ends in 5, we round to the even number, and the answer is 5,200. Dang it. I got overzealous.
Overzealous!
Absolutely not. Bobby, Bo, this is not okay. We are all going to make mistakes. We are not going to mock one another for our mistakes. We need to be able to be comfortable to make mistakes. We need to put ourselves out there because we learn from our mistakes. This is an important thing to know. This will be a safe place. Do you understand?
Yeah. Yes. Sorry, Billy. Sorry, Billy.
That's okay, guys. It didn't end in a perfect five. The arcane rounding rule only applies to ending in a perfect five. So this follows just the standard rounding rules, and because it ends in 5-3, which is greater than five, it rounds up to 5,300.
Great. Now, let's talk about how we actually work with significant figures in physics. The truth is that in physics, we really only rarely will take two numbers and combine them to get an answer. We usually end up doing what I like to call algebra, and there's usually quite a bit of it. So, we end up using the rule for multiplication and division. In other words, we end with the least number of significant figures from our givens. For example, if our known values are... Our displacement, or delta x, is 10.7 meters. Our initial velocity, or v sub I, is 14 meters per second. And our change in time, or delta t, is 72.040 seconds. How many significant digits should we have on our answer? Bo?
Well, let's see. Delta x was 10.7, and that has three significant digits. Velocity initial was 14, and that only has two significant digits. And the change of time was 72.040, and that's five significant figures. So the least number of significant figures was the velocity initial, which had two. So our answer should just have two significant figures.
Absolutely. Lastly, you should only round when you give an answer. You do not round in the middle of a problem. In fact, if part B of a problem uses the answer from part A, you should use the unrounded answer from part A to solve for part B and then round the correct number of significant figures. Ladies and gentle people, that is how you use significant figures and how you round in physics. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.
Lecture notes are available at flippingphysics.com. Please enjoy lecture notes responsibly.